Hi everybody. So last year, on the last day of school, June 30th, 2017, I retired from teaching in Chicago Public Schools after 30 years. I loved every minute of it and I love all my students so much. And because of FaceTime and other social media, I'm able to keep in contact with them, most of them, up to today. So on the last day, I told my students that I would do a teacher Q&A YouTube video, and they could write down any question that they wanted to ask me, and I would answer it in video. Now I have the stack of questions here. I haven't looked at them yet, but I'm going to look at them now, and I'll try to answer every one of them to the best of my ability. All right, here we go. What was your best day? Wow, my best day as a teacher was any day that I could see kids love learning, love reading, maybe a favorite book, hearing a favorite story, understanding a math concept and getting excited about it. That would be my favorite best day. Why did I want to be a teacher? I come from a long line of teachers. My dad was a teacher, my mom was a teacher, my brother is a principal. I have many great aunts that are teachers. And I love sharing my knowledge with others, so that's why I wanted to be a teacher. Who was my love? Oh my gosh. Okay, the love of my life, my soulmate, I think, was my college boyfriend, Jim Sinigular, from Liberia in West Africa. But I've had other loves too. So, all right, next. And that was from a student named Isaiah. Alani asked, "Dear Miss Lewis, do you like Volta? Because I love it. I love Volta. I loved Volta because it was such a diverse community, students coming from all over the world and all sorts of experiences, and a great teaching staff." Why do I live alone? I live alone because my children are grown and adults and raising their families on their own. But recently, my daughter and her family, Nigel, Luke, and Christopher, moved into my apartment because I decided to go traveling. Number two, what was my dream when I was small? I actually did dream to be a teacher. I also dreamed to be a pediatrician, which sometimes I think I wish I would have done that. What did your parents do when you were small? My mom was a teacher of adult basic education and also English as a second language. And my dad was a teacher of middle school, junior high history. What was your inspirational book that you've read in your whole life? Wow, that's a great question. You know what, I'm gonna set that aside and I'm gonna think about that for a minute. Because I asked me, why did I wanna become a teacher? Because my parents were, yes, that's probably a main reason why. And will you teach somewhere else or become a substitute? Yes, I might even become substitute teacher at Volta in May and June of 2018. So you might see me back there. But I would do plan and hope to teach English somewhere in the world. All right, Ridham, why do you want to be a teacher? I answered that already. And who inspired me to be a teacher? My favorite teacher, his name is Mr. Johnson. Well, he was one of my favorites. I have many favorites, but Mr. Johnson, because he read to us every day after lunch when I was in, I think, the sixth grade. And then another favorite teacher was Mrs. Olson. She was my first grade teacher, excellent teacher. Mrs. Elfke, I think she was my second grade teacher or third grade teacher. And we made stone soup, real stone soup, in our classroom after reading that book. What was my first school when I was a kid? My first school was Hutchinson Elementary School, and I went to that school from kindergarten to grade 6. Kush asked me, why do I wear makeup? And Kush, most of the time I didn't wear makeup because Kush told me when I wear makeup, I look really scary. Johnny. How do I put music on my channel? I'm not quite sure what you're asking, but I do know that if you want to put music on your YouTube channel, you have to get music that does not have a copyright on it. What made you want to explore the world? Well, Delani, I love learning about new cultures. I like seeing new places, and I also love tasting new foods. And I want to see the whole world. And she said at the bottom of her question, room 209 forever. Yes, that's true. What's my favorite thing? Wow, I'm a foodie. I love to eat new foods. So I'll say my favorite thing is food. And that's also a problem. That was from Suhan. What country will I go to next? Well, right now, as I film this video, I'm in Indonesia. I will be here for the next 3 weeks. And after Indonesia, I will be going on to Singapore. Who was your best daughter or kid that always helped you when you had a problem? Wow. I have 4 children. Jennifer, she's 31. Christopher, who passed away in 2015, and he was 27 at the time. Stephanie, she's 27. And Michael, he's 25. And my best daughter? Can't say. I love them equally. But my kids do always help me when I have a problem. They always say, Mom, you can do it. You're strong. You're the strongest person I know. Which school did I go to? So I already said Hutchinson Elementary. I also went to Hutchinson High School. And then I went to the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis for my elementary education degree. And I got my master's degree in language, literacy, and culture at the University of Illinois at Chicago. Angela asks, who was my best student? No. I've had thousands of students, and they're all my best student. Know that. You're my favorite, all of you. Who was my first love? My first love was actually in elementary school. It was love from afar. And his name was Danny Dinovic. If you're out there, hey, Danny. Let's see. Colin asks, what is your routine for a regular school day? So for a regular school day, I would get up at about 5 a.m. to get ready for school. I would run down to the train at between 5:30 and 6. I would take the Green Line to Clark and Lake, switch to the Brown Line. I take the Brown Line to Kimball, get off at Kimball, and usually walk to Volta. And then at school, oh my goodness, get all my materials ready and get a smile on my face and get all my energy up to meet my students. How long have I been a teacher? Oh, sorry. Sabrine asks, how long have I been a YouTuber? I started my YouTube channel when my son was in high school, so I guess I've had my YouTube channel for about 10 years, but I'm starting 2 new YouTube channels that I want to tell you about. One is called An Uncommon Traveler, which is a video vlog following my travels around the world. And the second one, I can't remember the title, but I'll be telling you because I'll be posting my first video tonight. And on that video, YouTube channel, I will be reading a chapter a day from a novel for young people. And my first book that I'll be reading is The Thing About Georgie, one of my all-time favorites. Gotta put my glasses on for this one. France says, would I take a student with you to travel? Do you want to travel with me, France? Oh man, I just heard from France's mom this morning. And I had sent him a special postcard from the Terracotta Warriors because he really enjoyed when we studied them. I would love for all my students to be able to travel with me. So if your parents give you permission, let's go. Okay. If I had to go to the Arctic or Antarctica, which would it be? Well, guess what? It would be Antarctica because my goal is to go to all 7 continents. Thanks, Krishna. Great question. Glenn, will you be a sub next year? She means in 2018. Yeah, I hope to be a sub at Volta. Oh, hope to see you there. Anthony, will I ever come back to Volta and tell us about your fantastic trips? Yes, Anthony. And Anthony also asked, will I ever wear makeup again? I love to wear makeup. Not very much, though. Just a little bit of mascara and a little help with my eyebrows. That's about it. And we're getting to the bottom. How did Miss Lewis finish the math when she said she's bad at subtraction? Okay, so this question is regarding on the last day of school, we had a competition. Myself and the three top students from Extra Math with the math facts. And you can see that video. It's on Johnny's channel and it's also on my channel. And it was very exciting. We had to do 100 facts in addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And the first one to finish would be the winner. Well, I was the winner. And I'm not bad at subtraction, but that's my slowest one. So anyway, I love math. Memorize your facts. It will help you with all math in your life. Oh, Mahi has 4 questions. Okay. Well, I have to change a few of them. Okay, so number 2 was, what made me divorce my husband? Well, you know, things happen. You know, he's a good person. Hi, Rodney. Will I ever forget you? I will never, never forget my students. I really, honestly, I love when they send me messages on any type of social media. I love to reconnect with them. I love communicating with them. Anyway, so if you're out there and you see this video and you want to communicate with me, hey, I'm open to it. And then, why do I write with a marker even if I have a pen? I write with a marker because I had surgery to remove extra skin on my arm after I lost 150 pounds. And when they were removing the skin, they cut a nerve, which made 3 of my fingers not, well, really more than 3, but these 3 fingers not have much feeling. And so it's hard for me to steady a pen or a pencil in my hand, so most of the time I use a marker. Great question. And then this last one, what was the most inspirational book that I've read in my life? You know, I love to read books. I love to read all kinds of books. But mostly I like to read biographies, autobiographies, or memoirs because I like to hear other people's stories about their real life. And it inspires me to do better in my own life and to realize that no matter who you are, famous, rich, poor, struggling, content, everybody has a story. Everybody has a story that we can learn from. And so when you think your life is taking a bad turn, read a book about someone else's life and it might inspire you. Okay, hope to see you soon on another video. I'm gonna be starting my new YouTube channel tonight. Be watching for it. I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna walk to one of the beaches in Seminyak and stop at a few shops. So hopefully I'll get some video footage of that and I'll be sharing that with you soon. Bye-bye, everybody.